All right, number nine, you might want to be careful. There's a hidden killer in your kitchen, rotting potatoes.
Oh, Lord.
Seriously, they can kill you. As potatoes rot, they release a toxic chemical called solanine. Typically, rotting potatoes have turned green. Have a good amount of this deadly toxin. A small bite of these toxic potatoes could kill a child.
Oh,
what?
Geez.
That turned dark.
For an adult, it would probably take several green potatoes to kill you, but even a little bit can cause vomiting, diarrhea, paralysis of the central nervous system.
Oh.
What is going on?
Yeah.
So how do you avoid all this? Store your potatoes in darkness.
Oh, yeah.
Solanine develops rapidly when potatoes are exposed to light. Also, don't eat any rotting green potatoes. Mm. I don't know. Do you have to tell people that? But I guess, geez, I didn't know they were that bad.
Get stressed out when you have a lot of uneaten produce in the refrigerator.
You do? You don't like a lot of
stressed out.
That's wasted money is what that is.
I like to buy groceries just for like a day or two out.
Yeah.
So you don't have like, produce.
I don't throw anything out. I calculate the amount of everything that's 99 cents of potatoes you're trying to throw out.
Yeah.
It's my wife all the time.
Yeah.
Eat it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Anyway. Number eight, let's talk about foot peels, Robin.
Oh, God.
Get your feet
sandal ready. I'm closing my eyes. I'm not watching this, I'm sure, horrifying video.
Get your feet sandal ready with mask aesthetics. Exfoliate and moisturize your feet. No, we're not showing any feet, I promise.
Yeah, right.
They're similar to face masks, but they're shaped like booties that you slip your feet inside of. An enthusiastic review from Elle magazine says years of damage peel off. Like a snake shedding its old gross skin.
Stop.
Listen, I have seen that. The feet out the passenger side window, I'm going to say right now, I've seen that way more this summer than I have. I don't know if this is catching on now, but we got to stop this because it's very hillbilly. You may not want to break out the open-toed shoes right after the treatment. Most warn you that exfoliation continues for about 5 days after you use them.
5 days?
Yeah.
And again, just to be clear, Robin, it's not just necessarily gross feet. Somebody could have the most adorable little feet ever, and you just do not like...
Don't like them.
Don't like feet anything.
I don't want to talk about it. I want to see file video.
Do you ever get pedicures? Do you get your feet worked on?
Occasionally, you have to get some work done, yes. Otherwise, it would be horrifying, you know? But it's nothing I enjoy.
So you're not just going to go for a leisurely foot massage type deal?
No. Huh. And I just... I know I have issues,
That's
got to
be a
Patrick.
Deal breaker. Mr. Rex was like...
Yeah.
Into the feet.
In the
feet. Is that a deal breaker?
Yes.
A deal breaker.
That'd be a deal breaker. Yeah, it's a non-starter.
God.
All right.
Number seven, here's something that's been debated for centuries. Is it butt naked or buck naked? Remember this clip that Pat did?
Once again, exploiting me in my body.
That clip has to be, was that in Indiana?
That was in Indiana at the Ponderosa Nudist Resort.
Right. Well, according to Merriam-Webster, buck naked and butt naked are both used to describe someone who's fully nude. Buck naked is the older of the two expressions. Butt naked is newer and likely seeing more use because of butt referring to someone's buttocks. Butt naked only starting being used in the late 1960s. You ever go back there and hang out with those your friends you made?
No, Dan, I can't say that I've gone back. I had some ambition back then that I would have done a piece where I had to pixelate that many.
Wait, was it you? Was it Ted?
Poor Ted Parra.
Poor Ted Parra.
He
had to. All that video.
He had to put up like he had to make curtains in the edit bay so that people weren't just
walking by
and seeing a random anteater. You know what I mean? The poor guy had to spend I spent a lot of time looking at that footage myself. Not that I'm disparaging anybody. The human body is beautiful.
But
just a lot of it. Too much of a good thing.
But you had to go through and get permission from each of the people that was being filmed, right? They didn't just give you, like, you could just
shoot
whatever you want?
Well, they put the word out that if you were going to be at the sun camp that day,
there would be cameras,
you were going to be videoed.
Because you had a lot of people show up for it.
They
don't care.
Wow.
How they live.
Oh, after 3 minutes, you see one, you see them all, man.
Words to live by.
All right, Tim.
Number six.
Yeah.
A new superyacht is living up to its name. Plans for Vast 72, luxury vessel featuring no fewer than three pools for those who prefer to take advantage of the surroundings. There's a, quote, beach club with a bar and a swim platform ordering direct access to the ocean. Hopefully it's not shark-filled waters. That's not all the amenities. There's also a helipad, a garage for all your favorite water toys, mm-hmm. and a gym. No word on whether the Art Deco style will stretch to those rooms. Yep. The yacht expected to be available by 2023. So get your bids in now. The price, of course, only available upon request. I like this.
But are you really happy if you don't have friends to fill up that yacht? No. I mean, really?
Truly.
Are you just being used for your super yacht? Do you have enough close friends to use that? Really?
Yeah.
I'd like to find out.
Yeah, I guess it'd be a good problem to have. Yeah. But all right. Number five, a new shatterproof light bulb. It's made out of silicone instead of glass. Look at that.
Wow.
Never breaks. The Incredibulb is what it's called. Designed for tight spaces where things could knock into it, like attics, basements, boat cabins. It's the same material. It's used for heat-resistant cookware.
Fun? You could bounce this, too. Yeah.
Look at that.
Oh, boy.
Also stays cool to the touch. And they're LED bulbs, so they're supposed to be just as bright as the glass bulbs. The company says they last 13 years.
These LED bulbs... I mean, as a homeowner, is a game changer. You're not changing light bulbs every.
I must be buying the wrong LED bulbs.
Me too.
What?
Me too. Me too.
They don't last 13 years for me.
No, they don't.
I never change them. I'm not kidding.
Are you a vampire? Where you have your lights off all the time?
Well, it works in the middle of the night.
If you use the lights, we're changing them every couple months still.
Yeah.
The LED, they're not, the LED lights.
Are there different levels of LED bulbs? Am I buying the cheap ones, which is entirely possible?
You shouldn't have to change them every 2-3 months. That's way too.
Maybe not every 2-3 months, but at least once a year.
But I've changed them, yeah.
Changed them enough.
I don't know, man. I'm never changing. I've been in my house 4 years and not changed a single LED bulb.
Maybe your wife's been changing all the bulbs and you're just not even aware of it.
I guarantee you she's not changing any of them.
Trouble at home, Dan?
I was going to say. Let's see, Dan, why is that?
Let's unpack that.
Are you doing everything, Dan?
Yeah, right.
Aww.
Oh, man.
And the dame won't cook either, see?
Where's Larry when you need him?
Oh, love you, honey, if you're watching.
Yeah.
Number four.
She's not watching.
She already texted me saying she likes my tie today.
Oh, God, love her.
Number four, 2021 is the summer of the P.S.
No,
pink suit. Doesn't say I'm just here for the party. It says I am the party. This is a Paul Conrad read, Tim, but they gave it to me.
I'm wearing the pink shirt.
Well, that's not white.
Yeah, I am
that's
too.
White.
I'm wearing
that's
pink
a very
shirt here.
Pink,
the king of the pink suit, more neutral T-shirt underneath, just to add a bit of casual, so you don't look like a try-hard.
Oh yeah.
You don't want to look like a try-hard.
No, you don't. My daughters tell me that all the time.
Yeah.
They called you a try-hard?
For the first time, I had.
Hard?
No, I wore like, you know, normally I've shorts on or something. I wear a pair of flats or something. So I actually got a pair of like those Adidas gym, like Stan Smith, you know, gym shoes, right?
Yep.
So I wore those out and they're like, come on, you look like a tryhard.
Oh.
I'm like, see? I mean, so you try and hip it up a little bit and then you just, why you bother?
Damned if you do, damned if you don't.
But they actually called you a tryhard?
Yeah.
I just learned that expression just as I read it on the teleprompter.
I've been hearing that in my house for 6 months already.
Did you know that? Like, it's tryhard?
My memory was refreshed. I've heard that before.
All right. Number three.
It's a bird. It's a plane. It's dinner. This is a Cessna 150. Back in 1978, Frenchman Michel Lotitio.
Nice.
I'm not so sure about that.
You won't get a Conrad read like that.
I don't know about that. My high school French belying me today. I began eating a plane just like this. Why? I don't know. Piece by piece, slowly but surely, it took him 2 years to consume the airplane.
What?
They say he had 9 tons of metal in his lifetime. No word on getting through TSA security checkpoints, though. Guinness Book of World Records gave him a brass plaque to mark this achievement. And you guessed it, he ate the plaque.
What?
A little confused by
that. Yeah, I am too. I don't understand.
But why? Lacking iron in his diet?
Yeah,
they have supplements for that.
Right.
It's not necessary.
Digestible substance.
Not typically.
I don't know. I don't get
just
it.
Just thinking of, you know what I'm thinking.
Yeah. It's got to go somewhere.
Passing that. Right?
Larry doesn't like that kind of talk.
Larry's not here,
Robin. No, he's not.
If he cared as much about that kind of talk, he'd be here. Number two, the person who found this one on a Facebook group is still trying to figure out if this is true or a joke. A couple was getting married, and they offered their wedding guests better food depending on how much their gift cost.
Oh, come on. That's ridiculous.
The RSVP invitation paired gift prices with food. A loving gift is up to $250 and offered options including roast chicken and swordfish. The silver gift is between $251 and $500, gets you a sliced steak and poached salmon. The golden gift, which is between $501 and $1,000, you'll eat filet mignon and lobster tails. For $1,001 to $2,500, the platinum gift, you'll get 2-pound lobsters in a souvenir champagne goblet. Vegetarian and kosher meals are available at the platinum gift.
What
level.
If they're like a sustaining member, like send them $30 a month?
Yeah, like a subscription.
Yeah, like NPR.
Yeah, you know, my old Italian relatives, they always give you an envelope filled with cash, and you don't give it to the bride and groom until after the meal. And if the meal isn't up to your liking, take a couple of 20s out.
Mm-hmm. All right, number one, check out this ad for Southern California yacht rock band Yachtly Crew.
Ah, the 70s and 80s, back when the songs were as big as the hair.
We don't just mean on their heads.
Yacht rock encompasses an ocean of music.
Steely Dan.
Christopher Cross.
Toto. And who hasn't been touched by Hall & Oates?
I know I have.
Sometimes at the same time.
But if that's not an option for you, there's...
Yachtly Crew.
This is brilliant.
Imagine hearing the greatest yacht rock songs of all time by the greatest yacht rock band of our time.
Yachtly Crew. Accept no imitations.
But wait, there's more. You don't even have to own a yacht.
Or be an old white guy.
To enjoy songs like...
I am all about this band.
That would be great. Street festival, bar mitzvah, wedding.
And they're where? In Southern California, did I say? I don't even listen to myself.
Right. Southern California. We'd fly them out, though. We'd get them on the show.
Would we? How long have you worked here? You don't know we're not flying anybody out.
No. Maybe they go on tour. We can have them, so. All right.
I like that. Fooled around and fell in love. That's a good one.
It was.
Don't you laugh at him. You're encouraging him.
Yeah,
he's not that funny.
Yeah, he's pretty funny.